Ever wonder how some plants at aquarium keepers maintain and keep very vibrant red aquarium plants? Well, in today's video, we're gonna break down the science of red aquarium plants and give you lots of tips and recommendations for achieving the absolute reddest aquarium plants possible. Welcome back to the Buce Plant Channel, where we cover everything aquascaping and we try and inspire and entertain you along the way. My name is Logan with Team Buce Plant, and before we dive into the science and the tips of red aquarium plants, be sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel for lots more cool content like this. We'll have all the links for the products we talk about in this video, as well as our specific recommendations for red aquarium plants down below in the video description. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Why are aquarium plants red in the first place? So most of the plants we keep in the aquarium hobby are a shade of green. And the reason they're green is because they have chlorophyll. And chlorophyll creates a green pigment that primarily reflects green light and absorbs red and blue light. And when a plant reflects something, that's what your eye sees. So aquarium plants that appear red to our eye still have chloroplasts. However, they have much more of something called anthocyanins. And anthocyanins are essentially pigments that absorb green light and reflect blue, red, and purple light. So to your eye, you see red. And outside of producing beautiful colors on a plant, anthocyanins serve a very important function for the plant's health. They protect it from stress like radiation and extreme temperatures. So anthocyanins essentially act as a sunscreen for the plant, protecting it from UV damage and ultimately cellular death. So while the in-depth biochemistry of anthocyanins is quite complicated, for all intents and purposes, this simple explanation lets you know a little bit about how red aquarium pigment works. How to bring out deeper reds. So how do we actually use this knowledge to our advantage and manipulate the conditions of our tanks to bring out deeper, more vibrant reds? Like most things in this hobby, your success and results are gonna rely on operating a very balanced tank. So we always go back to the substrate, the lighting, the CO2, the nutrients, as well as your maintenance. So let's start with the substrate. If you're gonna wanna bring out high quality, vibrant reds, you want a very nutrient rich substrate as opposed to inert substrate like a sand or a gravel. We recommend UNS Contra Soil. This is gonna provide the roots of your plants with everything they want to thrive and ultimately make more plant that is beautifully vibrant in color. Next up, let's cover CO2. While some plants can display reds without the presence of CO2, all plants first and foremost are going to benefit from the addition of CO2 because they primarily use carbon as their main building block for building more tissue and for expressing healthy, vibrant colors. So if you don't provide the plants with carbon like they get out in nature, they're just not going to give you the results you're looking for. And if you want to bring out super vibrant reds, it's a really bad idea to skip the carbon part. So go ahead and try injecting carbon into your aquarium. Over on the Buce Plant website, we've got tons of products to get you started with different budget levels. Go ahead and check the links in the description, as well as watch our video on how CO2 works and why plants need it. Next up is the lighting. And this is a very important part of the process, but it's also not the end all be all. It's really important that you have a high quality light, preferably one that you can modify the intensity and color spectrum with. And this is going to be really important in number one, achieving balance in your aquarium, but also pushing the limits of the intensity of your lighting a little bit, because after all, the more intense the lighting, typically plants will compensate to prevent any sort of cellular damage by creating more of those anthocyanins, which essentially acts as the plant's sunscreen. One final tip regarding the lighting is to actually manipulate the spectrum to favor more reds and blues. And for this, we recommend a light like the Chihiros RGB2. You can fully customize the lighting spectrum and manipulate it to your heart's content, all via the app. We also have an entire video on the science of lighting, breaking down all the different specs. Go ahead and check that out in the video description. Nutrients through fertilization are also an extremely important part about getting your plants to express vibrant reds. First and foremost, you want to make sure your plants have a balanced diet of macronutrients and micronutrients. While not the end-all be-all, iron is still highly important in contributing to a plant's health and helping it produce vibrant colors. So you want to make sure that your micronutrients include a healthy dose of iron. But equally important are going to to be the macronutrients in the micronutrients. However, where things get a little bit interesting is with a technique called lean dosing. By eliminating the amount of nitrates your plants get, many hobbyists have reported increased reds in their plants. So this is something you can absolutely try. It's called the lean method of dosing, aka nitrate limitation. And it's something that you want to do very carefully because some of your plants may suffer under nitrate limitation. So lower your nitrates a little bit or eliminate them for a few weeks, see what type of results you get with your reds and go from there. If you're interested in picking up some new fertilizer and experimenting with different combinations, we're proud to offer the Aquario Neo Solutions. This will allow you to dial in your fertilizer to the conditions that fit your tank and hopefully bring out some nice, deep, vibrant reds. Red plant recommendations. So with all of that knowledge under your belt, there are a variety of red plants in this hobby that are a mix of relatively easy to work with and some that are more challenging yet still rewarding. If you're a complete newbie to red aquarium plants and maybe you're not quite ready for CO2 and you don't have an amazing light, we recommend getting started with AR Mini. Even in low to mid-tech conditions, this plant is still gonna produce very nice hues. Now, of course, if you do give it the right lighting and hit it with some CO2, it's going to bring out very vibrant reds. Under the lower conditions, it may look a little bit more of a bronze, but still quite beautiful, and the undersides of the leaves almost always are a bright pink to red. Another relatively easy suggestion is Ludwigia Super Red. This plant doesn't always need to have CO2, though of course it will benefit from it. And typically Ludwigias are a stem plant that tend to be easier to grow. So if you want to get started with some pretty easy instant impact, go ahead and give that one a try. Finally, if you'd like a little bit more of a challenge with the promise of some extremely beautiful vibrant reds, go ahead and give Rotalas a try. A species like Rotala narrowleaf species red can be one of the most vibrant, intense reds in this hobby, but it's really gonna require some pristine conditions to get that way. So you're gonna wanna make sure that you're running a high-tech tank if you wanna truly bring out what this plant can offer. One tip with almost all aquarium plants is the more you trim them, the more vibrant their coloration will be, as well as the healthier and bushier their growth. So that's all the time we have for today's video. The science of red aquarium plants is quite complex if you want to dive into the biochemistry of it, but we believe that these simple tips and this cursory understanding of the science will give you all you need to get started. But as always, if you want to truly understand what's happening on a cellular level, go ahead and do a deep dive and feel free to check out some of the blogs we've got over on booceplant.com. Do us a favor though, let us know down below in the comments what your absolute favorite red aquarium plant in this hobby is. We'd love to hear from you. And if you like this type of content, be sure to like the video, share it with a friend, and subscribe to the channel for lots more like this. This has been Logan with Team Buce Plant. Now get out there and create something beautiful.